Hello, in today's video I'm going to share with you 10 top tips to ensure that your Australian Red Claw crayfish breed successfully in a tank setup.
Implementing these will increase your number of broods per year, increase the size of each brood, and produce faster growing, larger crayfish.
Tip number one is all about broodstock.
Breeding with poor quality broodstock will result in less successful mating, fewer broods, lower brood numbers, lower quality offspring, and a smaller final size grow out. Choosing a healthy strain of red claws should be your top priority when it comes to breeding. It will produce healthy, fast growing juveniles in large numbers that reach a larger final grow out size.
Tip number two is about how vital water temperature is when it comes to red claw crayfish breeding cycles.
If the water temperature is too low, typically below 23 degrees Celsius, Australian red claw crayfish will not breed. The preferred overall temperature range for all year round breeding is between 23 and 31 degrees. The ideal temperatures to stimulate spawning and increase the rate of spawning in red claw crayfish are between 28 and 30 degrees Celsius.
Tip number three is emphasising the importance of the pH level in your water.
It's essential to maintain stable water quality within the pH range, along with moderate water hardness to facilitate production successfully. The ideal pH level is between 7.0 and 8.5. This range promotes successful breeding, shell hardening, and overall growth. Testing the pH level of your water is quick and easy using either test strips or liquid kits. To use test strips, dip one into your water sample, wait for the colour to change, and then compare the resulting colour to the provided colour chart to determine the pH level. For greater accuracy, consider using a calibrated pH meter. This involves submerging the probe into the water and waiting for a stable reading on the digital display.
Tip number four is related to the age of your broodstock.
Australian red claw crayfish reach sexual maturity and can begin breeding from just 6 months of age. At this time, they typically weigh between 2 and 3 ounces. 6-month-old female red claws produce smaller broods and often fewer broods per year when compared to those larger females of 12 months or more. Selecting crayfish older than 6 months also makes it easier to choose the best quality brood stock.
Tip number five is all about your stocking ratio.
Achieving the right balance of sexually mature males to females is crucial for the successful breeding of red claws. If there are too many males, fighting will occur. Conversely, if there are too many females, it can lead to unfertilized eggs, commonly referred to as berries. On our farm, we maintain a ratio of 3 females for every male in our selective breeding program.
Tip number six is the importance of a correct diet.
For breeding Australian red claw crayfish, the best diets consist of formulated commercial feeds or high quality homemade options. A simple balanced diet of shrimp pellets, grains and aquatic vegetation provides the necessary nutrients for reproduction. Additionally, a varied diet that includes components such as fish food, earthworms and brine shrimp are beneficial for successful breeding. It's important to note that as red claw crayfish get older, their protein requirements decrease.
Tip number seven is the stocking density of your tank.
If you stock too few crayfish broodstock, then your reproduction volume will be low. But if you stock too many, fights will inevitably occur and water quality may suffer. For optimal breeding of red claws, maintain a stocking density of 1 to 2 mature crayfish per square foot in tanks, or a maximum of 20 crayfish per square meter.
Tip number eight is about creating a suitable habitat for breeding.
Red claws that are stressed won't successfully reproduce in any significant numbers. Your crayfish tank needs an abundance of shelters, such as mesh bundles, pipes, rocks, pieces of wood, and other suitable hiding places to minimize stress levels. Ensure your tank setup contains more hiding places than the number of crayfish stocked.
Tip number 9 is about oxygen levels.
Proper aeration is essential because crayfish respiration increases under stress. Maintaining healthy oxygen levels is crucial to prevent suffocation and ensure their survival. Adult red claw crayfish can tolerate dissolved oxygen levels as low as 1 part per million. However, for optimal breeding conditions, dissolved oxygen levels should be maintained above 5 parts per million. To ensure adequate oxygenation in the breeding tank, it is advisable to use air pumps with air stones or to provide sufficient water flow from a filter system. On our farm, we currently use only air pumps and air stones. We have also successfully hatched hundreds of thousands of baby crayfish without the need for oxygen. However, unless you're experienced and willing to carry out daily inspections and regular water changes, we recommend using an air pump in your breeding setup.
Tip number 10 is about refreshing your broodstock bloodline.
An Australian red claw crayfish typically lives for 4 to 5 years, though some can live up to 6 years under optimal tank conditions. However, this longevity doesn't necessarily mean you should keep breeding the same adults until they eventually die. Making regular additions to your crayfish broodstock with new bloodlines will prevent inbreeding and help maintain a healthy and robust population for years to come.
Now that you know how to successfully breed your Australian red claw crayfish, here's a video to show you how to set up the breeding tank step by step. We also have this playlist for you to enjoy.